Hi, I'm Sally Streib, the author of Summer of the Shark. Summer of the Shark is the second book in a three-part series beginning with Treasures by the Sea. In these books, I've woven three threads together: storyline, nature, and the word. Because four fabulous things happen as you weave these three threads together, I'd like to show you what I mean. Diving in the Bahamas is one of the things I love to do best, and one day between two dives, I walked along the beach. I saw a table-like rock jutting out into the ocean. I wanted to go across that rock and see what lay in the water in front of it. I slipped and slithered my way across the rock, reached down quickly before a wave could come to find what might be hiding in some of the crevices. As soon as I did that, a rogue wave came. It lassoed my feet and took me off balance, plastered me into the wall of water, and began to rush toward shore. I did what divers know to do when caught in a wave. I dove deep, getting down to the sand and trying to make my way around the front of that rock. That's when I saw these tiny black and white shells. I had to have one, so I reached out and twisted it loose. And in looking at it later when I was deposited up onto the beach, I realized I had something sturdy, something strong, but not very exciting. And I asked God, what's so great about a West Indian top shell? And he said, shh, and look closer. One day I decided to take the shells up to my dentist's office. My friend there used his dental tools, and we took the skin off this top shell and discovered that it was really a very beautiful pearl. It reflects all the colors of the rainbow. And getting even more snoopy, we decided to cut it open. And when we cut it open, we realized the beauty of the symmetry of how this shell was formed. Now, four great things happens when you hear a story like this. The first thing is that nature captures your curiosity. You want to know what this is about. And the second thing is nature lifts your affections to God, because you look at God and you say, look what he made. Isn't he wonderful? When your affections are open and your curiosity is going, the third thing happens, and that is nature teaches truth. This particular shell teaches me to look closer. John 1:29, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Or, behold God who takes away your desire for sin. Looking closer. Now, the fourth thing, equally exciting, is that truth is anchored in your emotions and in your mind. Whenever you see a shell in the future, you're going to think of this little story. And this is the basis for this series of books. I want to thank you for your passion for books and for making it possible for me to share with the young people.